chapter 24, right under our noses. Dale pumped like he could outpedal the storm, made balanced on his handlebars, the storm's flat, angry hand shoving us along the blacktop. Dale stood up on the pedals, panting as the front wheel began to squeak. There was something about that sound, the sound of metal, the whirling squeak. Stop! I know where Miss Lena is! He slammed on his brakes, catapulting me off my perch. Where? He panted. Right under our noses! Dale looked down and then out across a pitching ocean of corn, its green leaves going silver beneath the rolling sky. I don't see her. Get back on. The old Blalock place, I said, pointing to the sandy path etching its way across the corn. It's the perfect hiding place. Ain't nobody been there since Miss Blalock died last winter. Nobody except us hunting daffodils, or maybe Redneck Red to check on the steel. Everybody pretends he ain't running. Miss Lane is down that path. I know it. Star already searched the empty houses. Get on. Deputy Marla's already searched, I said. He braced against the wind. Daddy might be home, Mo. I gotta go. Just a few minutes, I begged, stepping in front of the bike. Remember how Miss Blalock's old water tower squeaks when the wind blows? That's the sound I heard when Slate called. The wind raked his hair. I got a foolproof plan. Take us 5 minutes off. 5 minutes, save Miss Lena's life. He bit his lip. I don't know. I hear the Blalock's place is haunted, that everything's just like she left it. And Lavender says Miss Blalock's TV comes on at odd times and she changes the channels herself. I snorted. Don't be a baby. 5 minutes. You'll be a hero. He sighed. 5 minutes, Mo, but that's all. 10 minutes later, we ditched the bike and hid behind the hydrangea. Stay low, I whispered, glancing at the wooden water tower in the side yard. Slate's been here. Sure's my name's Mo LeBeau, I added, nodded toward the tire tracks and the drive. Anybody could have left those tracks. What's your foolproof plan? I'm getting to that, I said, trying hard to think of one. First, I do my surveillance. Then, I'll explain my strategy, which is genius quality, believe me. His shoulders slumped. You don't have a plan, do you? I knew it, he said, his eyes closed. I knew not to come to the ghost farm with you during a hurricane. Shh, I'm casing the place, I said, my gaze taking in the neat white house and lingering on the padlocked front door. It's locked tight, just like people say. What was that? Did you hear a TV? No, I didn't hear a TV, I said, still an uneasy feeling settled cool hands against my neck. I swallowed hard and turned my attention to the side yard and the old water tower with its bandied legs and pot belly. Its windmill had lost an arm, but it whirled to battle each gust of approaching storm. Faintly, I heard it screak, screak. It was the water tower, I heard, no doubt about it. Only there's no way you could hear it from the inside Miss Blalock's house. Slate wasn't inside when he called. Thank you, Jesus, Dale whispered. He must have been closer to the tower. I glanced at the pump house. Its thick curtain of kudzu was torn. Someone had opened that door. She's in that pump house, I said, my heart pounding. Come on, we're on search and rescue. If you see Slate, give me a signal. I do a nice owl, he suggested. Fine. If you see Slate, hoot like an owl. Now fan out. Dale shook his head. There's only two of us. You gotta have three to fan, and that's at the very least. Okay, forget fanning. We'll surround the pump house. You go around the back and I'll take the door. No, he said firmly. It's too snaky in back. I'll go to the door. Snakes are mean enough in good weather. There's no telling how they think with a hurricane coming. I took a deep breath. The colonel says sometimes all a leader can do is see which way everybody's going and try to get in front. This looks like one of those times. Okay, we'll both take the door. Follow me. I crouched low and sprinted across the yard to the pump house, Dale on my heels. Miss Lena, are you there? Screak. I grabbed the door's rusty latch. Miss Lena. A shaft of light pierced the shed's gloomy heart. Inside, I could just make out a case of old mason jars, a rusted rake, and a wooden bucket rotted half through. She ain't here, I said, my heart tumbling. No, Dale said, kicking at an old knee-high bottle. I'm sorry, Mo, let's go home. Behind us, a tree limb thumped against the side of the house. What the? He glanced back at the house and screamed, the sound slicing me like razors as he dove to my feet. What? I shouted, falling to the ground beside. Did you see Slate? I thought you were going to hoot like an owl. It's Miss Blalock's ghost, he cried, his face ashen. Where? In the house, he said, his eyes glassy with fear. She flitted past the window. Thunk. I squinted past the dancing broom straw. That ain't no ghost. Somebody's in there. I sprinted across the yard to the back porch. Miss Blalock's heavy back door scraped across the kitchen's faded linoleum. The rumors were right. The kitchen stood just as Miss Blalock left it in the morning she died. Table set for one, a paper dry daffodil in a mason jar, a cast iron frying pan on the stove. Miss Lena, I whispered, the wind groaning and the roof rattled. Let's try the living room, I murmured, looking away from the table. It looked too lonely, too abandoned, too close to being alive. Dale grabbed my arm. What's that smell? He said, sniffing the air. I scanned the kitchen. Pizza boxers littered the counter. Pizza Hut delivers out here, he gasped. He tiptoed to the boxes, opened the top one, and sniffed again. Empty, but fresh. At least Miss Lena ain't hungry. I crept to the living room. The room sat prim and proper. A torn curtain fluttered by a cracked window pane. There's your ghost, I said. And then, as my eyes adjusted, I saw something else. Blood. Blood on the floor. Blood on the shattered lamp. Blood on the faded wallpaper. Miss Lena, where are you? We tore through the creaking house, yanking open doors, calling her name. She ain't here, Dale panted, his face pale as he'd forgotten his ghost. Follow the blood, I said, heading back to the living room's wallpaper and placing my hand against her handprint. There, I said, pointing. We followed a faint smear of blood across the room and down the hall to a door. As I pushed the door open, the wind grabbed it, jerking me onto the porch. Scuff marks scarred the dirt drive and disappeared into a crisscross of tire tracks. She was fighting good, Dale said, his voice shaking. The pecan trees flailed at the darkening sky, and an old fertilizer bag cartwheeled across the yard. The storm's first raindrops spattered into the dust, the size of dimes. He's moved her. We gotta get some help. Come on, Mama's closest, he said, running towards his bike. She'll know what to do.